Hello my crafty friends, this is Monica from Allsewpetite. Welcome back to my channel. Are you tired of sewing projects that leave you with messy and fraying edges that don't look quite right? If so, then it's time to learn about French seams. This sewing technique creates a clean, professional look on any project, from delicate dresses to sturdy tote bags. In fact, French seams are particularly great on bags because they provide a strong and durable finish that can withstand the wear and tear of everyday use. In this tutorial, I will show you how to sew French seam so you can achieve that professional finished look that you've been dreaming about. So grab your fabric and let's get started. As you can see, I have two pieces of fabric here, which I will sew together using French seam. But before you start, I would highly recommend amending your seam allowance to 1.5 centimeters or 5/8 of an inch, because we are going to sew the seam twice. Once at 5 millimeters or 1/4 of an inch, and then one more time using 1 centimeter or 3/8 of an inch seam allowance. So 1.5 centimeter or 5/8 of an inch seam allowance is perfect to use on French seam. To begin, place your fabric wrong sides together, not the right sides together as usually. You're going to place it with wrong sides together. So I'm going to sew this top seam here. So I'm going to line up the edges. If you have pins or clips, you can pin or clip that seam in place. Here we go. Then we're going to take this to the machine and we're going to sew the first seam using 5 millimeter seam allowance. After you stitch that seam, you're going to take this to the pressing station, open your panels, and press the seam allowance to one direction. It doesn't really matter to which direction you're pressing. Just like that. Then you're going to place the fabrics right sides together. You will need to line up your seam so it is nice and flat. And then you can press it with an iron again. So once you have that nice and flat, you're going to take this to the machine and we're going to sew the second seam using 1 centimeter seam allowance. So once you have that stitched, you're going to open your panels and then you can press the seam allowance to either direction. You will see that the raw edges are now completely enclosed inside the seam. This results in a clean and professional looking finish that will not fray. French seams can take a little bit of extra time and effort, but the end result is well worth it. If you enjoyed this tutorial, let me know in the comments and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for similar content. See you next time. Stay crafty, friends.